Locking differential? Electronically controlled limited slip differential? Have you ever wondered what these terms actually mean? For that matter, have you ever wondered what a differential is to begin with? Toyota uses a variety of differentials in the vehicles across its lineup, so let's find out a little more about what this component actually does and what the differences are between the various kinds. Let's start at the top. How do vehicles go around a curve if their wheels are connected by an axle? Think about it. When making a turn, the outside wheels need to travel faster than the inside wheels, since they're covering a greater distance, a bigger arc. This would be impossible if both sides were locked together on the same axle. Well, the answer lies in something called a differential. Put simply, a differential is a cleverly designed central gearbox that allows both sides of an axle to rotate independently while still receiving power from a single power source, like an engine or electric motor. As one of the most basic principles of automotive engineering, differentials can be found on every consumer vehicle available, including the entire Toyota line. Without them, going around every turn would be quite unpleasant due to the wheels constantly skipping. Differentials can be found wherever they're needed to distribute power. That means on front-wheel drive vehicles, the differential is located on the front axle, built into the transmission to be precise, while rear-wheel drive vehicles have one on the rear axle. And in the case of some full-time four-wheel and all-wheel drive vehicles, not only are they needed for side-to-side independence on both axles, but also for front-to-rear freedom, using something called a center differential. So now, a differential solves one problem, but introduces a new one in the process. Everything we've described so far has fallen under the open differential category, meaning both sides are completely free to rotate as they like. So now, what if one of those wheels was resting on a patch of ice? Well, thanks to that differential, the power will simply follow the path of least resistance. In this case, that means going straight to that one on the ice and just spinning it, getting you nowhere. So now, we must find a way to ensure the power goes to the other side where there's traction. Luckily, there's several ways to solve this, all of which can be found throughout the Toyota lineup, depending on which application suits which model best. For instance, there are mechanical solutions called limited slip or locking differentials, which, as the names imply, use mechanical means to either limit the amount of power going to each side, or even just lock them together entirely. In addition, some Toyota models are equipped with electronically controlled systems that can achieve similar effects simply through clever application of the brakes, as well as torque vectoring electronic differential systems that actively manage the power output to each wheel, proactively sending power to the side that needs it. In some cases, that happens even before any slippage occurs. All in all, differentials are a fascinating part of automotive design that not only help vehicles go around curves, but can also help improve traction and stability in a wide range of situations.